The isolation of Galapagos from any other landmass was key, is key, to the future of the biodiversity of the Galapagos Islands. This isolation, traditionally of course, was the ocean, 600 miles of rolling oceanic seas, which was difficult to cross for many creatures, including small birds. Now, with the daily aircraft arriving, weekly boats, cargo boats, there is always the risk of them bringing something with them.
The first and the most invasive species are humans. Humans brought dogs, cats, rats, some of them accidentally. And these species are producing a lot of impact on the birds.
In 2015, I personally got extremely concerned about the fate of these birds. We don't want these birds to go extinct. They deserve to survive.
Many small land bird populations in the Galapagos Islands are declining. One of the main factors is Falmouth downsy parasitism. Falmouth downsy is a fly. It's about the size of a common house fly.
Although a fly is a fly, it has to be realized that this is the greatest danger that the small birds of Galapagos face. They may well go extinct if we do not control a small fly.
In the 1990s, we first discovered Falmouth downsy parasitizing land birds. Females lay eggs in the nests of birds. Once these fly eggs hatch within a nest, the larvae worm-like stage eats blood and tissue from the baby birds. These birds have no defense mechanisms against a nest parasite. We're looking for nests of small land birds. We're tracking these nests, monitoring them. And then we're also doing experimental treatments with an insect growth inhibitor inside the nest to try to control the larvae and pupae stages of the Falmouth. The emotional toll of the effects of Falmouth downsy during work is very heavy sometimes. Sometimes I'm tracking nests and I find baby birds inside a nest. I see them every day, every couple days, alive and active, and then I find them dead in the nest. And to know that they're killed by Falmouth, by this fly, is very heartbreaking. Two of our short-term solutions for controlling Falmouth involve an insecticide that is injected into the nest base. Sterile insect technique is where you raise a lot of flies in a lab, you sterilize all the males via radiation, then you release them into the wild, and the wild females will mate with these males that are sterile, thus producing unfertile eggs, and so overall it'll decrease the population.
The long solution is biotic control, so we are looking for the natural enemies. So we know right now that a small wasp, they call it Conura annulifera, they will be the possible control biological.
My favorite bird here is the little vermilion flycatcher. It's endemic to the Galapagos. And we found that Falmouth affect drastically the vermilion flycatchers.
I have friends who've lived all their lives here, and they would say, you know, there used to be vermilion flycatchers around our farm. And it was an inspiration to us, for these little birds flittering around in the mists and fog, and it was like there was like a sort of spiritual thing in it.
Falmouth downsy, a fly, is not a very charismatic species, and many people won't find it very interesting or feel compelled to help or share or donate money just to understand the biology of a fly or control a fly. But if we put it in the context of the famous Darwin finches, the other endemic and native land birds in Galapagos, and all the baby birds that are dying from the effects of this fly, potentially these people will have more heart to try to help us find a solution.
Galapagos is a key spot within the whole world. It represents nature and the incredible power of evolution.
So I want to provide something for the future, because, you know, if we don't do anything right now, maybe in 50 years some species will not be present.
We are working really hard to help these birds, but we need to help to share this information, and we need to your support for your donation.
I just don't think you should ever give up. I think you have to go on. Never say it's too late and we're going home. And the planet can't stand that.